Hajime Tabata, the director of Final Fantasy XV, has done quite a few interviews in the past couple of years, and they've been fired at us from numerous sources, whether that be the active time reports where he'd answer questions from Fujisan, or from more traditional publications like this one from Kotaku and this one from Famitsu. Some of them have even been rather critical of the company and the franchise he was working on, while others ended up putting him in some hot water with the community because of his rather clumsy honesty. But I feel as though the interview he just conducted with Eurogamer is perhaps the best interview he's done to date. And I'd like to give real credit here to Martin Robertson from Eurogamer for the flowing nature of the interview, as well as the questions he ended up asking. Now, things started off pretty casually in the interview, as they spoke about the ending of the game. But I won't go into that particular answer, as it delves into some spoilers relating to the game's logo. Next up though, the discussion went on to Tabata's role with the Final Fantasy XV project, and whether he'd want to put himself through directing another main series Final Fantasy game again. It's actually something that he's addressed somewhat before. Now, if you cast your minds back to February, he spoke to DualShockers about Sakaguchi's seeming disapproval after he learned that Tabata wanted to work on a new IP next instead of working on another Final Fantasy game. But Tabata did say that the motivation does exist for him to make a mainline Final Fantasy game if he was able to work on it from the start. With Eurogamer, he elaborated on this a bit more by saying he's now 50-50 on the idea of directing another Final Fantasy title. But he's more confident now that if he did direct another game in the series, he would be able to do a much better job next time round, something which kind of set the tone for the bulk of the rest of the interview, as Tabata opened up more about the struggles that he endured with Final Fantasy XV and the toll it took on his staff. He also offered a more honest appraisal of the final product and why they decided to carry on working on the game next year. Now, Tabata has spoken before about how he essentially had to restructure the entire development team working on Final Fantasy XV towards being something of a meritocracy. And that seems to be something of a bugbear for him, as alongside stating that he would want to obviously make a better game next time around, he feels that he would be able to do a lot better with the management of the development teams. He specifically said that the way Japanese companies are structured placed a number of limitations on what he wanted to do, because of how staff are handled and assigned to things. He cited it as a big burden, but it's something he feels that he's more equipped to handle from now on. What he said next was also quite interesting to me. He states that Final Fantasy XV wasn't meant to be a game for the Japanese market, as it was a game targeted at a global audience, and that if he was to make another one, he'd want to make it a truly global title next time around. Now, at this point, I do have to say that I don't mean to essentially run through the interview line by line, and I'll put a link in the description so you can do that for yourself should you wish, but I find the whole thing fascinating, so I want to try and dissect as much of it as possible. For example, in the next question, Tabata was asked about the biggest regrets with the project, and as we've come to expect, he was pretty honest in his appraisal of things. It's something I personally admire about his approach to the media, even if it does frustrate me from time to time. He spoke about how when they finished up with Final Fantasy XV, they literally had no bandwidth left at all, and to skip around a bit, he said that even though the game may have needed it, there was no way he could have delayed the project any further. Not just because the fans had been waiting for the game for 10 years, but because of the sanity of his staff members. He said, the project had been going on for 10 years at that point. Projects have a lifespan, and there's a certain limit you can take them to. You talk about limits. The team, the people making the game, they're already way beyond their limits of their stamina and capacity. If I was going to take that away, that psychological pressure, and overwrite that with a new objective and goal, that wouldn't have worked out, so that wasn't an option. And it's true, I think it's often quite easy for us to sit on this side of the fence and be quite judgmental, but no matter what we think about the final product, it's clear that Tabata and his team poured their hearts and souls into Final Fantasy XV. It sounds like the prospect of delaying the game even further would have just broken the team. And as we learned from his talk following GDC, morale on the project had been quite rocky as it was, something that Tabata's family day helped to raise back up by getting everyone's families on board with the project, not just the development team. In terms of what he regretted, well, they relate both to content and delivery. The first thing was that he really wanted to get the Regalia Type D ready for launch so that the car didn't feel as restrictive. This was obviously added in as a free update at the end of June. The second was that they wanted to make the transition to the more linear second half of the game much more gradual, as opposed to the more abrupt transition we ended up getting. Giving a more honest appraisal of how things went, he also said his biggest regret related to the delivery of the story. He said that following the game's launch, they became very aware that the way they presented things didn't pan out as they had expected, and this didn't just relate to the main game, but also the other stories and the content surrounding it. As we saw in our recent Final Fantasy XV post-release community survey, this was also a particular point of contention with Final Fantasy XV. People felt that the story delivery was poor and that the wider universe just didn't meet the standards they were expecting. It sounds like Tabata agrees. He said that by creating the universe, it offered a lot of points of entry for the game, but there are also a lot of people who only played the main game, and they ended up getting the feeling that they were missing out on some important parts of the story as a result. He also noted that upon release, they realized that even within the main game itself, the core story of the world, the mythos they were looking to deliver, it ended up coming across as sparse and in some cases just missing. It's why they essentially ended up creating the post-launch roadmap and the service model they've ended up delivering. They felt that they did the best they could with the time they had, but they ultimately knew that they had to continue to improve and add to the game after release to make up for these deficiencies. He was also quite honest in the fact that Final Fantasy XV made a lot of profit for the company upon launch, and he felt he owed it to the fans to invest that profit back into the game by continuing to release the content they wanted to have ready for launch but didn't have time, but for no additional charge. He also just loves the community, and felt that by adopting this type of model for post-game content, it would allow him to continue being connected to them, as opposed to just disappearing as we often see happen. The team wanted to have a much longer relationship with the community, which is something that's actually rather uncommon for Square Enix. And that's definitely something I would personally agree with. Outside of the mobile titles, which are of course constantly evolving, it's very uncommon to still be talking about a game this long after release, especially with so much interest still surrounding it. You can see from the number of views on our videos that there's still very much an appetite surrounding new information around Final Fantasy XV, and you have to give Tabata credit for not shying away from it, but instead choosing to embrace the fanbase. But when does he feel the game is going to be complete? Well, that's the point of next year's content. He realized that even though they had a year's worth of content planned that would end up running until the end of 2017, that wouldn't satisfy the fanbase. He therefore wants to try and finish it all up in 2018 and have a big climax at the end. However, he also revealed that he's going to be taking a lot of steer from the community on how things should go. By collating all of the feedback from the in-game surveys, attending events, and generally monitoring the community, he's devised what he feels is the perfect plan for how Final Fantasy XV should conclude. Eurogamer rightly pointed out that that's a somewhat dangerous precedent, having millions of people essentially direct the game as opposed to relying purely on his own vision, but he explained that games have different phases. He said that pre-release, obviously they try and listen to feedback from potential players, but that ultimately they steer the game in the direction they internally feel is right as the creators. However, post-launch, there are many, many more opinions, and it's all about deciding what the majority want to be improved. And I feel it makes perfect sense if you think about it that way. Pre-launch, there are obviously going to be glaring issues that they may have to look into altering, but aside from that, they will typically stick with their vision. However, post-launch, it's all about fixing people's issues and concerns. With typical games or with Final Fantasy XV, this relates to fixing bugs and making small improvements. And after hearing what's out there, developers have to decide what to spend their time on, which will typically be decided by which issues have the most complaints about them. Based on this, Tabata has broken down next year's plan into essentially two tracks. One where they will look to enhance the game and make it even better for those who are already happy with it, and another where they will try and bring back those who played it but weren't happy and moved away from it. To that end, Tabata revealed that there are still over 100 people within the team working on Final Fantasy XV at this moment, and given their commitment into next year, that number is likely to stay around the same figure until they look to ramp up work on their next big project, which is apparently going to be targeted at next generation systems. In terms of how Tabata feels Final Fantasy XV has affected the future of the franchise, well, he feels as though it opened the franchise up to a wider audience, and he's actually quite proud of that as he feels it's opened the door for the next game to take on new challenges. And while he was pretty tight-lipped about Final Fantasy XVI, he did have some advice for the director who decides to take the reins on that project. He said, you better be prepared to put your whole life into the project, and he pointed to the dedicated fan base and said, you can't do any less for them than that. So yeah, as I said, I felt this was a pretty awesome interview, and it was honestly quite refreshing to see Tabata speak so candidly about Final Fantasy XV, what it meant for him, and also the team. But I also liked the fact he was open about talking about where he felt it fell short and what they're trying to address with things. I'd also like to think that he has genuinely learned a lot from Final Fantasy XV, but then again, they keep still releasing more properties in the Final Fantasy XV universe, so I'm not too sure how much has actually sunk in, but I have to believe. I'd also really like to encourage you guys to go out and read the full interview on Eurogame if you have the time. It's a really good read, end to end, and as I said at the beginning, I have to give real credit to Martin Robinson over at Eurogamer for conducting the interview in this manner. But either way, how do you guys feel about all of this? Did you think it was pretty interesting like I did? And if so, what did you think about Tabata's responses to the questions he was asked? As always, let us know in the comments below, and if you enjoyed this video, please hit that like button and subscribe to our channel. And also, if you'd like to support us on Patreon and help this channel grow, please head over to patreon.com/FFUnion. You are a mighty wall of supporters before you. If you pledge even on the lowest tier, you will get your name featured alongside these awesome folks and get access to our awesome upcoming giveaways. Alright guys, that's enough from me. This is Daryl signing out. I'll see you next time for more Final Fantasy videos.